Hey everyone, how's it going? Hope you're all doing great. In this video right here, I'm going to be showing you guys how to use Git. Now, before we get started, you'll need to download and install Git on your system. And so if you head over to git-scm.com, you'll be able to do that very easily. Simply just click download the file and then just double click to install. It's pretty straightforward. So what we're going to do is we're going to start you guys off something very simple. So I'm going to head over to the terminal. All right. So once you've installed Git, what you'll need to do is configure your Git correctly. What do I mean by that? So before we do anything, let's test if Git actually works. So if you do git-version, it's going to show you the Git version, right? If you see this, then it means Git is actually working. Now, the next thing you're going to need to do is, you know, configure it, give it your name, right? Because Git will track, you know, all your work, and your work needs to be signed off by someone, right? In this case, you want to use your name and your email. So what you do is git config global user.name, and then you type in your first and last name over here, and git config global user.email, and then your email. Simple enough. So why are we doing this? Well, initially, you know, this might be like, seem like, well, why am I just telling you to do all this stuff? Well, it'll, you know, reveal itself in the next few seconds. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to create a new directory, right? So I'm just going to create a new directory project. So mkdir. So this is mkdir. It's just the command line version of, of creating a folder. Now, if you're not familiar with command line, don't worry. I'm going to go really slow and explain everything step by step. If you are on Windows, you probably don't have this terminal, so you will probably have to use something like the command prompt to type all these commands in. And on Windows, the commands might probably be a little bit different, but they're not that hard to figure out. And if you're not comfortable with the command, you can just go and create a new folder somewhere. But just make sure that you can reference it in the command line again. All right, so with that out of the way, let's go ahead and create our folder, git workflow. You can call it whatever you want. As long as you know where it is. So I'm going to cd into that. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to open this up in my text editor. And before I do anything, I'm going to create a file over here. I'm going to call it readme.md. So I have one file in my Git workflow folder. I'm going to head back to my terminal. And what I'm going to do is git init and dot. So this is going to initialize Git in my work directory, in my repository. So let's do a git status. So it's going to tell me that, you know, there's an untracked file, readme.md. So by default, Git doesn't track every file that you have. So you're going to have to manually add this into Git for it to track. So the way we do that is git add readme.md. Git status. So now it tells us that, okay, this file has been added. You know, there's a new file coming up. This is now when you see this green color over here, this is what we call the staging area, right? So there's actually nothing saved yet. There's no commits yet. It's just staging to show what's going to happen when you make the commit. All right. So another point to note is if your terminal looks different from mine, it's because I'm using what we call Z shell. If you're on a Mac, chances are you're probably using Bash by default. I have a video showing you how to set up Z shell, and it looks really nice, and you can see the branch over here just like this. So that's very cool. It shows you which branch you're working on in Git. It'll be very helpful if you're using Git to use Z shell. So I'm going to link to that video over here, and you guys can click and take a look at that, and it'll show you how to set all that up in that video. All right, with that out of the way, let's continue. So here we are, we are creating our first file. We're going to create our first commit. So I've added this file. So what I'm going to do is git commit m, and I'm going to say created our first readme. All right, so we have our first commit. Now, what I'm going to do to check my commit is do git log. So here I can check out, you know, my commit, and my commit tells me, okay, it's the author. This is where that, you know, first the name and the email configuration comes in. It tells us, you know, what basically, you know, what I did, the message that I wrote in this commit. And I can also take a look, you know, into the commit. We'll get into that a little bit later. So for now, what I'm going to show you is how to, you know, once we make a change to a file, what's the flow, what's the step, right? So right now we just have an empty file. So this is a great place to start. So I'm going to enlarge the text a little bit. So here we are. I'm going to create my first line of code. So this is just pseudocode. Don't worry about the code. That's not the focus of this video. The focus of this video is to get you guys going with Git. So this is my first line. No one ever. All right. So now I've made some changes to my file. What I'm going to do is git status. It's going to tell me that there's a change made in the file because it's tracking this file now. Remember, we added that to the to git. So it's now tracking this file. So to see the changes, I can do git diff readme.md. So you can see here, it tells you the all the lines of code that was added. So now what I can do is git add and then readme.md again. Now good status. You'll see that it says that this file has been modified and it's staged. So if I make a commit, this change is going to be committed into my repository. So what I can do is git commit m added first line of code. Great. All right. So now we have our first commit. We can take a look at the git log again. Git log. Very cool. So we can actually see our commits and see our log and, you know, see like the read the message of what happened over here. So that's pretty simple. So if you want to, for example, if you want to see how I escaped, got out of that git log, so you can do git log. You can click, hit Q, the Q button. It's going to quit out of the log and then you come back to your terminal. All right, guys, I think that's it for this video. In the next video, we're going to be covering a little bit more advanced topic called branches and what branches can do for you and your workflow. All right, guys, if you find this useful, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends and family. And I will see you guys in the next one.